See, unlike America would have us believe, the greatest problem confronting this country today is not pollution and bad breath. It's black people. It's black people. See, that's just one of the big lies that America tells you and that you go for because you chumps. You go for it. One of the lies that we tell ourselves is that we are making progress. But here his chair is empty. We're not making progress. We tend to equate progress with concessions. We can no longer make that mistake. You see, when they gave us that nigger astronaut, you say we were making progress, but I told you they were gonna lose him in space. He didn't get that far. You put Adam Powell in office and you couldn't keep him. What you think they're gonna do with Thurgood Marshall when they get tired of him? They gave you Walter Washington of Washington, D.C., and you said we were making progress. That's not progress. See, it's no in-between. You're either free or you're a slave. There's no such thing as second-class citizenship. But a lot of you running around talking about you Democrats, and the Democrats got you in the biggest trick going. They tell you it ain't our fault. It's the Dixocrats. There's no such thing as a Dixocrat. The only difference between George Wallace and Lyndon Johnson is one of them's wife got cancer. That's the only difference. You go for it because you chumps. You go for it. The only thing that's going to free Huey is gunpowder. Black powder. That's no victory, that's a concession. When black people become serious about the revolutionary struggle that they are caught up in, whether they recognize it or not, when they begin to go down and knock off people who are oppressing them and begin to render these people impotent, that's when the revolutionary struggle unfolds. Not until.
We have to recognize who our major enemy is. The major enemy is not your brother, flesh of your flesh, and blood of your blood. The major enemy is the honky and his institutions of racism. That's the major enemy. That is the major enemy. And whenever anybody prepares for revolutionary warfare, you concentrate on the major enemy. We're not strong enough to fight each other and also fight him. We will not fight each other today. We will not fight each other. There will be no fights in the black community among black people. There will just be people who will be off. There will be no fights. There will be no disruptions. We are going to be united. We must begin to develop, number one, and this is the most important thing we can do as a people. We must first develop an undying love for our people. Our people. Our people. Our people. We must develop an undying love as is personified in Brother Huey P. Newton. Undying love for our people. Undying love. If we do not do that, we will be wiped out. We must develop an undying love for our people. Our slogan will become, first our people, then and only then, me and you as individuals. Our people first. Our people first.
Huey Newton is the only living revolutionary in this country today. He has paid his dues. He paid his dues. How many white folks you killed today? But you revolutionaries, you are revolutionaries. Che Guevara says it's only two ways to leave the battlefield, victorious or dead. Huey is in jail. Johnson can always sit up and talk about, he can always raise an argument about law and order because he never talks about justice. But black people fall for that same argument and they go around talking about lawbreakers. We did not make the laws in this country. We are neither morally nor legally confined to those laws. Those laws that keep them up keep us down. You got to begin to understand that. And in ending, I want to end in the Swahili saying. It says, Lasima tusinda bila shaka, which means, we shall conquer without a doubt. Black power.
And so in talking about Brother Huey Newton tonight, we have to talk about the struggle of black people, not only in the United States, but in the world today, and how he becomes part and parcel of that struggle, how we move on so that our people will survive America. All right. Therefore, we are not talking about politics tonight. We're not talking about economics tonight. We are talking about the survival of a race of people. That is all that is at stake. We are talking about the survival of black people. Nothing else. Nothing else. Nothing. And he will consciously wipe us out. He will consciously wipe us out. Let us check World War II. He will not do it unto his own. Notice who he dropped an atomic bomb on. Some helpless yellow people in Hiroshima. Some helpless yellow people in Hiroshima. In Hiroshima. If you do not think he's capable of committing genocide against us, check out what he's doing to our brothers in Vietnam. Check out what he's doing in Vietnam. We have to understand that we're talking about our survival and nothing else. Whether or not this beautiful race of people is going to survive on the earth. That's what we're talking about. Nothing else. Nothing else. If you do not think he's capable of wiping us out, check out the white race. Wherever they have gone, they have ruled, conquered, murdered, and plagued. Whether they are the majority or the minority, they always rule. They always rule. Always rule. And check out the pattern in which they move. They came to this country. They didn't know a damn thing about this country. The red man showed them how to adapt to this country. He showed them how to grow corn. He showed them how to hunt. And when the Indians finished showing it, he wiped them out. He wiped them out. He wiped them out. He was not satisfied. He went to South America. The Aztec Indians said, "This is our silver. This is our copper. These are our medals. These are our statues. We build them for the beauty of our people." After the Indians showed it to him, he took it and he wiped them out. He wiped them out. He's been able to make us hate each other. He has transplanted that hate and the love for each other for a love of his country. His country. We came to this country as black men and as Africans. It took us 400 years to become Negroes. Understand that. That means that the concept of a black man is one who recognizes his cultural, his historical, and the roots of his great ancestors who were the greatest warriors on the face of this earth. Africans. 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 Many of our people's minds have been whitewashed. If a Negro comes up to you and you turn your back on him, he's got to run to the hunky. We're going to take time and patience with our people because they're ours. They're ours. All of the Uncle Toms, we're gonna sit down and we're gonna talk. And when they slap, we're gonna bow. And when they slap, we're gonna bow. And we're gonna try to bring them home. And if they don't come home, we're gonna off them. That's all. That's all. The three M's. The missionaries, the money, and the Marines. That is precisely the way it's moved all over the world. It is the way it moves against us. They have sent the missionaries in. We sent them out. They have sent the money in with the poverty program. The Vietnamese and the Koreans are pulling the money out. The next thing comes the Marines. Comes the Marines. And if we're talking seriously, we get prepared for the Marines. Now, if some black people do not think that the white man is going to wipe us out completely, then it won't be no harm being prepared just in case he decides to do it. Just in case he decides to do it. So there'll be no harm in us preparing ourselves for the Marines. Now, there's a lot of tactics we can learn. The VC has shown us the best way to get it done. Best way to get it done. And don't be afraid to say it. Tell them, yeah, you want the Vietnamese to defeat them, cause they're wrong from the jump. They're wrong from the jump. They're wrong. They're wrong. Don't get up there and play games with them. You ever see them on TV? Well, actually, we were wrong going into Vietnam, but we can't get out unless we save face. To save that hunky's face, millions of Vietnamese got to die. That's a lot of junk. If you're wrong, say you're wrong and get out. Get out. Get out. Get out. Get out.